फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो टुडे वी शैल से द डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम एंड द डिफरेंट टर्म्स यूज्ड इन द दिस वाइब्रेशन सब्जेक्ट। सो दिस टू कॉन्सेप्ट्स सो वी शैल सी इन डिटेल टुडे। सो इज इट माय वॉइस इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन? तो मेरा आवाज सभी को आ रहा है ना क्लियरली?
हाँ सर।
ओके ठीक है, थैंक यू। ओके सो टुडे सो वी शैल सी द डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम फर्स्ट। सो एवरीवन वी नो दैट व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम। सो इट इज नॉट जस्ट यूज्ड इन दिस सब्जेक्ट इन वाइब्रेशन, सो इट इज यूज्ड इन डिफरेंट डिफरेंट सब्जेक्ट्स। सो इट इज यूज्ड इन थ्योरीज ऑफ मशीन्स, so it is used in the design of machine elements. So generally we can define the degrees of freedom as number of independent coordinates required to define the motion of any body. Okay, so it is in general concept. So generally like this we can define it. So in this subject, in the vibration, so in the dynamics of machinery, DOM subject, so we can define that number of parameters required to define the that vibration of the body, vibration of the any component. So that is called the degrees of freedom, so with respect to the vibration. So here degrees of freedom are classified like single degree freedom system, double, 2 degree, 3 degree, and so on, multiple degree freedom system. Means how many parameters required to define the degrees of freedom, so that is called the degrees of freedom. So single degree freedom system, so first is single degree freedom system. Means if the number of parameters are required is only one, so if the number of parameters required are only one, then that is called the single degree freedom system. So suppose you can say, so this is a one object. So if you are twisting this object, this disc, so twisting means it is rotating. So in case of rotation, so which type of motion it is? It is an angular motion. So which concepts will come here, which parameter will come, is that is angle, that is theta. Means only one parameter is required here to define the vibration or motion of the body. So isko kya bolte hum? So we will say it as a single degree freedom system. So here also you can see, so this is the motion of a simple object, so which is traveling in the linear direction. So when it is traveling in this direction only, so there is, so motion in other directions is restricted. Agar if you take the best example is a train. So train kya hota hai, so jo railway tracks hota hai to uske upar simple movement hota hai, means it is only one direction. So in that case only one parameter is required. So this kind of systems, this type of systems are called the single degree freedom system. Okay, so next is 2 degree freedom system. So 2 degree freedom system means here its meaning is, so number of parameters required are 2 to define the vibration of the body. So then it is called the 2 degree freedom system. Agar do parameter chahiye agar vibration ko define karne ke liye any component or body, to usko hum kya bolte hain 2 degree freedom system. So here you can see, so this is the object, isko kya bolte hain, so this is called the spring and this is called the mass. देखो इफ यू टेक एनी बॉडी तो उसका क्या होता है, उसका एक मास होता है, मींस इट विल बी हैविंग सम मास, सो व्हिच इज रिप्रेजेंटेड इन टर्म्स ऑफ केजी. तो उसके बाद सो इट विल बी हैविंग सम स्टिफनेस, सो इट इज डिनोटेड बाय द के. सो हियर यू कैन से दैट दिस ऑब्जेक्ट, सो दिस ऑब्जेक्ट इज हैविंग द two parameters, this object required the two parameters to define its vibration. So here you can say, so this is x1 parameter and this x2 parameters, means there are two parameters required to define the vibration of the body. So then this type of systems are called the 2 degree freedom system. So here also you can see the example. So it is a disc mounted on the shaft. So how many number of discs are there here? Here there are 2 discs. So here what happens is, so it may be rotated in angular direction, as it can also rotate in the angular direction. Means here what happens is, so total parameters it will become 2 for the 2 discs. So it is theta 1 and theta 2. Means here vibration, if you want to define the vibration of this body, so you require the 2 parameters, theta 1 and theta 2. So that's why, so this system is having 2 degree of freedom. So next here also you can say, so this is a one mass, it is reciprocating, so it is a piston and cylinder, so it is a connecting rod, you can say. So here what happens is, so if you want to define the complete vibration of this body, so what you require is this linear direction of this mass and this angular direction of this connecting rod. Means here you require the 2 parameters, that is x and theta. So this is called the 2 degree freedom system. So next is 3 degree freedom system. Okay, so 3 degree freedom system, so in this case, so number of parameters required are 3. So as the name itself indicates, so number of parameters required is 3 to define the vibration of the system. So here you can see, so this is the, so how many masses are there here in this system? There are 3 masses, so x1, x2 and x3. So number of springs are 4. So here motion of this total vibration of this system can be defined if we know the value of x1, value of x2 and value of x3. So that means, so we required the 3 parameters to define the vibration of this body. So that means it is having the 3 degree of freedom system. So here also you can see, so this is the object, so it is a shaft, on that different discs are mounted. So here the figure is not clear here. So here is also disc is mounted. Here also. First one disc, second disc, and third disc. So if we want to define the vibration of the system, so we require the theta 1, theta 2 and theta 3. Means we require the three parameters to define the vibration of the body. So here also you can see one more example. So it is having three masses. So it is having the linear object. So here also we require the different three parameters x1, x2 and x3, y1, y2 and y3, that is theta 1, theta 2 and theta 3. So we require the minimum three parameters to define the vibration of the body. So where the number of parameters required 3, then it is called the 3-degree freedom system. So next is infinite degree of freedom system. So it is important here. Infinite means अभी हमने देखा, so single degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, so on. If you take, so we can directly go for the infinite degree of freedom. So it is, you can say this is example of, that is cantilever beam. So cantilever beam is having the infinite degree of freedom. इसमें degrees of freedom एक limit नहीं होता इसमें. So it will be having the infinite degree of freedom. Means we require the infinite number of parameters to define the vibration of this body. So that's why it is called the infinite degree of freedom. So that is about the degrees of freedom: single degree, 2 degree, 3 degree and infinite degree. So if it is 4 number of parameters required, then it is called 4-degree freedom system, so on. So next is basic terms used in vibration. So if you are going to study any subject, so before going through that subject, so we need to understand, so we need to know the different terms used in that particular subject. Same way, so here before I am going to study this complete subject, vibration subject, so we shall see that what are the different terms, so that is used and what are its meanings. Okay, so that we shall see. So here you can see, so this is the vibration. So vibration means different types hota hai, simple harmonic motion, so linear vibration, so different types of vibrations. So that we shall see on later on. So here, so I am considering the simple harmonic motion, that is SHM. So because why I have considered this? So because, so this will easy for you to understand. So already आपको simple harmonic motion क्या होता है तो आपको पता है, तो इसलिए मैंने इसको consider किया. देखो, so what are the different terms? First of all, amplitude. So amplitude का मतलब क्या होता है? It is the maximum displacement from the mean position. अभी देखो, so here it is a mean position. So इससे a mean position से maximum कितना displacement होता है? So that is called the amplitude. So it is defined in terms of the meter. That is SI unit of the amplitude is meter. Okay. So next is period. Period means it is, that is time taken to complete the one cycle. Okay. So that is called the period. So here, so it is 50% and it is 50%. Suppose if you take instead of here, you will get confused. So from this point, so when the vibration is happening, so from this point to this point means it will complete one cycle. Okay. सो एक साइकिल को कंप्लीट करने के लिए जो टाइम लेता है, टाइम टेकन टू कंप्लीट द वन साइकिल इज कॉल्ड द पीरियड. सो द सेम अदर पैरामीटर, सो फ्रीक्वेंसी मीन्स वी कैन डिफाइन फ्रीक्वेंसी एज दैट इज नंबर ऑफ साइकिल्स दैट इज गोइंग टू दैट आर गोइंग टू बी कंप्लीटेड गोइंग टू कंप्लीट इन वन सेकेंड. So that is called frequency. So frequency is defined in terms of the cycles per second. That is hertz. देखो, first of all, periodic motion. Periodic motion क्या होता है? So vibration is a periodic motion. Periodic motion means what? The motion that repeats after equal interval of time. So if you take the any object, vibration कैसे होता है? So it will happen is again always it will going to rotate, means it will going to vibrate. So means it is a to and fro motion. So periodic motion means so the motion which repeats after equal interval of time. So that is called the period. So next is time period. So just we have seen the period, you can say time period also. मीन्स टाइम टेकन टू कम्प्लीट वन साइकिल. तो एक साइकिल को कम्प्लीट करने के लिए जो टाइम लेता है तो उसको क्या बोलते हैं? सो इट इज कॉल्ड द टाइम पीरियड. प्रज्वल, प्रज्वल मेरा आवाज आ रहा है क्या? So anyone can confirm so whether you are getting voice or not clearly.
Sir, आ रहा है आवाज?
राहुल, आ रहा है ना क्लियरली?
हाँ सर, आ रहा है सर.
ओके, ठीक है. ओके, सो टाइम पीरियड. सो व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ टाइम पीरियड? सो टाइम टेकन टू कम्प्लीट द वन साइकिल. सो एक साइकिल को कम्प्लीट करने के लिए जो टाइम लेता है तो दैट इज कॉल्ड द टाइम पीरियड. नेक्स्ट इज सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन. सो वट इज मीनिंग ऑफ सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन? इट इज ए पीरियडिक मोशन. पीरियडिक मीन्स इट इज दैट रिपीट्स आफ्टर इक्वल इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम. पीरियडिक मोशन ऑफ पार्टिकल हूज acceleration is always directed towards its mean position. So jiska jo acceleration hai na, so SHM mein kya hota hai? So acceleration is always so directed towards the mean position. Mean position means so just I have shown that. So this is called the mean position. This is called the mean position. So in case of SHM, simple harmonic motion, so acceleration is always directed towards the mean position. So and proportional to the distance from its mean position. Okay, so proportional to the distance from mean position means jitna distance mean position se badhte jata hai to utna acceleration kam hote jata hai. So it is proportionality. Okay, so that is called the simple harmonic motion. So in short it is called the SHM. So next is amplitude of motion. So just I explained in the figure. So it is maximum displacement of vibrating body from its mean position. So mean position se jitna maximum displacement ho sakta hai hota hai, so it is called the amplitude of motion. So next is important concept, free vibration. So abhi maine vibration, the types of vibration mein, so I explained about free and forced vibration, damped and undamped vibration. So different types of vibrations. So free vibration means vibration due to its own elastic property. Vibration due to own elastic property. So means if you touch any body, suppose if you take the pen, So if you take the pen, so initially what I am going to do is starting में मैं force apply करूँगा, apply करके मैं छोड़ दूँगा. So I will apply the force and I will leave it. So उसके बाद afterwards it should vibrate itself, खुद ही vibrate होना चाहिए. उसको क्या बोलते हैं? So that is called the free vibration. So vibration, the body which vibrates itself due to elastic property after applying the initial force. एक बार force apply करने के बाद उसको मन force apply करके छोड़ देने को उसको, तो उसके बाद जो vibrate होता है itself, vibrate itself because of its elastic properties. So that is called the free vibration. So forced vibration means it is different. Forced vibration means it is vibration due to external force. Means usme continuously force apply kiya jata hai. If you are applying the force continuously, so because of that, so whatever the vibration, so that is called the forced vibration. So example is machines, manufacturing machines. So manufacturing machines like CNC, VNC machines, where the motor is continuously runs, jo actuators hota hai. So for actuators means example it is electric motor. So it runs continuously. So tool ko run karne ke liye. So because of that, so force continuously forces will be applied on the different parts of the machines. So because of that, so machines parts are going to vibrate. So that is called the forced vibration. Free vibration means only starting mein force apply karne ka. So forced vibration means it is continuously application of the forces. So this is the difference between free vibration and forced vibrations. So next is important parameter is resonance. Resonance means it is a natural frequency. Resonance means it is a natural frequency is equal to the external applied force. So if you take any body, it will be having its own natural frequency. Natural frequency means the frequency at which it vibrates with maximum amplitude. It vibrates with maximum amplitude. सबसे ज्यादा vibrate होना start हो जाता है, तो उस frequency को क्या बोलते हैं? So that is called the natural frequency. अगर उस जिसका natural frequency रहता है तो एक्सटर्नल फोर्स के साथ मैच हो गए, दैट मीन्स नेचुरल फ्रिक्वेंसी इज इक्वल टू द एक्सटर्नल अप्लाइड फोर्स. एक्सटर्नल अप्लाइड फोर्स का जो मैच हो गया तो उसके बाद वाइब्रेशन क्या हो जाता है? सो इट विल बी वेरी हाई. सो उसके बाद क्या होता है? उसका साउंड आना स्टार्ट हो जाता है. वाइब्रेशन का देखो आप, ज़्यादा वाइब्रेशन हुआ तो सो इट विल क्रिएट्स नॉइज. सो दैट फेनोमेनन, दैट प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड द रेजोनेंस. Okay, so next is damping. So damping means, so abhi kya hota hai? So because of vibrations, so because of vibration of the parts, so it will going to increase the stresses induced. Abhi mai humne discuss kiya tha ki what are the advantages and disadvantages of vibration. So there are more disadvantages than advantages. So it will unnecessarily creates the stresses in the material, stresses in the parts. So because of that, so failure of the parts are going to take place. Agar, so if you want to reduce the vibrations, agar aapko vibrations ko reduce karne ke, to what we can do is we have to use the damping. So we can use the damping. Damping means, so it is some material. So it is the resistance to the motion of the vibrating body. So suppose if you use the proper damping, so it will resist the motion of the vibrating body. Vibration jo hota hai usko resist karta hai, so because of which it brings the vibrating body to rest or equilibrium. Vibrating body kya hota hai? Usko reduce kar dete, vibration ko reduce karke usko it will bring body to the rest or equilibrium. So it is very important. So in you can say, so we are going to use the damping, different damping systems, so in different objects, especially where the vibrations are more. So सो ज्यादा वाइब्रेशन होने से सो पार्ट्स आर गोइंग टू ब्रेक समटाइम्स सो फेल्यूर आर गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट सो इफ यू वांट टू अवॉइड दैट सो वी हैव टू यूज द डैम्पिंग सो नेक्स्ट इज स्टिफनेस सो स्प्रिंग स्टिफनेस सो stiffness means it is a force required for you can say it is not written here force required for the unit displacement of the spring agar if you take any spring so usko how much force required so that spring will displace for the unit distance so means force required for unit displacement of the spring is called the stiffness of the spring so stiffness of the spring so it is defined force per unit displacement so its unit is newton per meter so kitna force chahiye spring ko ek unit ka displacement karne ke liye to usko kya bolte hai spring stiffness So it is expressed in terms of the newton per meter. Okay, so this is all about different terms used in the subject. Also, degrees of freedom. Okay, so this is. About today's lecture so if you have any doubts so you can let me know so that I will clear your doubts kisi ko kuch doubts hai to puch sakta hai so that I will clear your doubts Prajwal mera awaaz aa raha hai na Prajwal ka
haan sir
आवाज रिप्लाई नहीं कर रहा था इसके पहले ओके ठीक है राव स्वप्निल
यस सर
हाँ एनी डाउट्स कुछ डाउट्स
है क्या आपको ऑल
क्लियर ओके सो रोहित
Yes, sir.
So I have you understood about the today's lecture? आपको
हाँ सर
मैं क्या लेक्चर आज का लेक्चर का
हाँ हाँ
okay so is it everyone is understanding so our subject
yes
समझ में आ रहा है
sir
ओके ठीक है सो इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर सो वी शैल सी द नेक्स्ट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वाइब्रेशंस ओके सो नाउ टुडे सो आई एम गोइंग टू एंड द लेक्चर नाउ सो आई होप नो वन इज हैविंग एनी डाउट्स ओके ठीक है चलो बाय टेक केयर